Good morning, everyone. This is Mitch over at IndySoft. It is Tip Tuesday. This week, I'm going to let my most recent demos that I've done kind of drive where I'm going to do this tip for you this week. Last week and even yesterday, I got asked several times about how does IndySoft handle storing images or photos of your equipment into the system? So I think many of our customers probably are aware of the fact that we have the equipment image field, where you can actually navigate and select an image, and you know, you just navigate and select whichever photo you want, and that ties that to that equipment record. Okay, so most customers are aware of that. However, there's a couple of different options on where we can make that image visible for you. Before I move on to the, I'll show you where those things can be. I will state that you do not have to select your images at the item, at the individual item level. If you're our template users, of course, you can set up an image name and an image file at the template level. So if I were to open up my template system, you'll see that in my Fluke 87 template, I'm referencing that particular image as well, or you have the option to do that at the template level also. Okay, so templates, you certainly can do that there. But our image field, on this particular layout that I'm looking at on the screen here, I've got this larger image here of this Fluke 87. And again, it's designed to be sort of a stock photo. Now, another option you have is you can actually move your images over here to the right panel. Okay. Now, I've already previously set this up. So if I toggle over to a different layout, you'll notice there's that particular stock photo. Okay. So in the system, you have the ability to take the images, put them directly into your equipment screen layouts or over on the right side. Just a preference there. Now, another neat tool that I think will benefit both of our commercial calibration customers who have receiving and shipping operators who are actually bringing in equipment, and sometimes just having a stock photo can significantly help. But I also think these images will be able to benefit our tool crib environments, our manufacturer and enterprise customers who are checking tools in and out, because sometimes you may have an attendant that is not as knowledgeable about the equipment as a metrology technician. So in the system, you know, these stock photos, yes, they're visible here on the equipment view, but we also give you the ability to make them visible during your transactions, or, you know, as we all call that, our events. So in the system, let's assume that I was going to execute a checkout event on this particular instrument, and let's say I was going to check this out to a particular location. You'll notice here now I've got that image visible right here in my checkout panel. Now you can of course maximize these and move your events around as needed, but as you add your equipment in, sometimes it's quite nice to have that ability to see a stock photo to make sure what's being checked in or checked out, it is the actual proper tool. Of course, you know, with proper labeling and things like that, that wouldn't necessarily be the case. But just having a stock photo can benefit both our tooling, our calibration enterprise customers, and also our commercial calibration customers. Now, another thing that I want to talk about with images, and this is what actually came out of a meeting yesterday, was what's the proper way to document damage to an instrument? Now, should you use maybe the stock photo field as an option for that? Potentially, that is certainly an option for you. But what I encourage most folks to do is when you have things like damage, you want to document that as an event. That way you actually can require certain fields, require documentation, and have a date and time stamp to it. So you'll notice on this particular piece of equipment, I've got an event that I've previously performed just a few moments ago where I documented damage. And I even put a note in here that shows where my screen shows a little excessive wear. Now, the way that we do that is in your event system, you just take advantage of the event documents. So I've built an event here called document damage. And if we open this up, you know, you can have some various different fields in here, you know, whether it impacts performance and things like that. But we want to give you the ability to put comments in, of course. So, you know, let me just place a comment in here and I'll just say the screen shows surface scratches, but is fully functional. Okay, so I'll just place a little comment in. Now, of course, what I'll do is I'll, you know, add in my instrument. So again, there's my stock photo. However, when we go in and we hit finish on this event, and we'll go ahead and move that to next. Not finish, I'm sorry. But what we'll do is we'll go to the event document step. So in the event system, If you want to attach like a real-time photo at a certain date and time, I encourage you to do that with this event documents area. So if we go in, you can actually attach or add an event document. And I may just want to say screen scratches, kind of give it a label so you know what it is when you're looking at it in your history grid. We're going to date and time stamp that for you. Then you can even apply comments if needed. But I'm just going to navigate out and I'm going to grab this picture that I've actually already got pre-staged here. So I'm essentially taking an image, storing that in the system. Now what we'll see is when we complete this event, now I have a documented step in my items history showing that there's my document or there's my screen damage, there's my note, and we're even going to store a copy of that photo in the system or that event attachment. So to me, if you have stock photos, maybe a piece of equipment set up or installed on a piece of machinery, then I would use your stock equipment image options for that. And again, the way you do that is you'll just select the image field and you just actually go out and navigate to that photo that you want to attach in. The system will actually start to store a folder of these in the database. That way you don't have, 75 of the exact same stock photo of a Fluke 87. We don't want that in the system either. So you can either choose your images from just somewhere on your network, and then I'll load that into the database, or you actually will have a folder that'll start to build up from within the database as well. The other option, again, that we talked about in this video is you can make your images visible here on your equipment view or over here on the right side of your equipment view. Now, in my database, I have these two different views kind of pre-staged, so you'll see that there already. However, we do give you the ability where you can actually control. Do you want it over here on the right side, or again, or do you prefer it to be embedded in? The way that we do that is I'm just going to go and modify a layout and show you this real quick. So in your equipment layouts, which in Layout Builder you have this option, there's an object here, this or a command here that's called Equipment Image Insert. So I can actually take this field and move that anywhere I want. So let's say I want my images to be all the way down here at the bottom. I can just put that there. So now when I refresh and save, it's going to take that image and put it down at the bottom of the screen. Okay. If we want the image to actually be over on the right side panel, the way that you do that is you actually just remove this in its entirety. So if you actually just remove the command called Equipment Image Insert, that's going to be the command that makes that image visible over on the right side of your layout. So again, if we remove it, it's going to end up over here on the right-hand side. And then if we were to use that in our layout, so if, I've got that in mind here. Let's say I want to move that to the bottom. I'll just save that here. I'll hit save and move the image field. This is our new configuration check-in tool here if you haven't used that. So what I did is I just moved that now to the bottom. And of course, that's going to require a refresh. But once I do that, you're actually going to see that get placed down here at the bottom. So you're actually in full control on where you want to place those images on your layout. Again, anywhere on the full screen, or you can actually put it over here on the right side. So I hope this is a helpful video. I think for our tool cribs, this is a great tool because it allows your tool crib attendants to see a piece of equipment and know kind of what they should be looking for. That's the concept there. For our commercial calibration labs, I certainly think for your common instrument types like a Fluke 87, a Fluke 45, a 6-inch caliper, I don't ever expect you to load to photos of those in the database because your calibration operators and your technicians will certainly know what those pieces of equipment are. But on those less common types, I definitely think it can help our commercial calibration customers as well. And then in the example that we did earlier with the Fluke 87, I definitely think that just having the ability to document damage to items when it's there. You can either do that as a separate event, like I did in this illustration, or for our commercial labs, it may be good just to have an option to do that in your receiving events, potentially in the calibration event as well, if a technician is the one who notices the damage. So, anyways, I hope this is a helpful video. I hope you guys have a fantastic week. And if you ever have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out to me or our IndySoft support team. Thank you and have a great day.